So today we're going to make what Jenna calls a zucchini tart. Is that what you call it? A zucchini tart. From the James McNair Squash Cookbook. He's a guy from out in San Francisco in Lake Tahoe area. And his recipe is a zucchini, leek, and chèvre with wild rice crust. We're not using chèvre. We're gonna use mozzarella because you use what you got. And the key to this piece is the inside, the bulk of the tart is like a French custard, and it's really contrasted by the crunchiness of the wild rice. And then we have, do you know where the black wild rice is from? A lot of wild rice grown up in the Northwest, up in Wisconsin. Huge rice fields up in Wisconsin. And so what are the ingredients we have today, Janet?
Well, there's zucchini and leeks.
Okay, so we got zucchini. Oops, little lighting mishap here. Zucchini, where are the zucchini from?
Freda's Farm.
Freda's Farm. And leeks.
Stillman's that were in my freezer from last fall.
That's right. We're still working off last year's produce in preparation for this year's haul. And then got some mozzarella just from the supermarket. Anything special about the mozzarella? Except in the future, we can make our own mozzarella. Then we have some light cream from which we get delivered weekly Saturday mornings from Thatcher Farm in Milton. They used to have dairy cattle there, but now it's coming in from Vermont. Just basic salt and some eggs and some sweet cream butter.
So I made the crust this afternoon. This is a wild rice crust. You need 2.5 cups of cooked wild rice. I cooked it in a little bit of vegetable broth to give it some extra taste. I added an egg, a couple tablespoons of lemon, and some grated Parmesan cheese, and put it in the oven for 15 minutes to firm it up at 350. Okay. And now it's cooled down.
So what's that?
So I also chopped up a zucchini, two zucchinis, in two leeks, and sauteed them in butter until they're done. Now I'm giving you the recipe for a full-size pie. What I'm actually making is, like a 9-inch pie. I actually made a smaller one because there's just two of us. So if you want to make a smaller one, just cut everything in half.
The eggs, making the egg mixture.
How many eggs?
Again, I'm making a small one, so it's 2 eggs and 3/4 of a cup of milk or cream. You can use whatever you want.
White cream.
Yeah, and then you're going to whip it up. And add some, this is marjoram from my garden. So
let's get a close-up of the marjoram. Mm. What do the leaves look like so that you can identify them if you're out? Okay, hold it still there. Kind of tiny variegated leaves, but they're thick. Kind of thick like a miniature sage or something, huh?
Yeah, you need a couple tablespoons. If you prefer, you can use thyme or whatever herb you like.
So we have a set of spices for cooking like that.
Just want to cut them a little bit to release the flavor. And throw it in.
And this is what behind us, some mint on hand, but we're not going to use that.
Okay, and okay. Then a little Dijon mustard, a squirt of Dijon mustard. And you're going to whip it all up. And put the pie together. Okay, now we're going to just put it together. You put the zucchini and leeks in here. And by the way, if you don't have leeks, you can use onion. I do that a lot. When I don't have any leeks, just use onion. So you spread it around and then you pour the
egg mixture in on top. And then you sprinkle the cheese on and you stick it in the oven for at 350.
I was reading there's a reason so many things are baked at 350.
Really? What's that?
I don't remember.
That's helpful. Alrighty, now I'm going to put it in the oven. Okay, so now while the pie is baking in the oven, and you need it in the oven for about 30 minutes or so.
At 350.
At 350. We're going to take the grated, did I tell you what I did to this? I grated zucchini.
No.
And I salted it and drained it in a colander, and then I just put it here. You want it to get as dry as it can.
So the salt helps to draw the water out.
And then in small batches, you fry it.
Hot oil.
In hot oil. This is olive oil. You know, the recipe says to deep fry it, but I don't like to deep fry things. So I just saute it until it's brown and crispy. And the wetter the zucchini is, the longer it takes.
Okay.
Okay, so this zucchini's almost crisped up. It does take a little while to do it. Just be patient and it gets done.
And we just...
So it's nice and crispy. And then you're going to put it on a towel to...
Okay,
and then once it's nice and crispy, you're just going to put it on a paper towel to drain.
And we just, the last few minutes, we had to turn the temperature down because we were getting little whiffs of smoke, and that means the olive oil is starting to burn. It's gone above its burn temperature. So you have to be careful. If you don't have a sense of how hot you can go with your pans and gas set up or stove set up, then you can adjust the burn temperature up by adding a little bit of vegetable oil.
And it's ready to come out of the oven.
Okay, let's take a look. Nice.
Yeah. There you go. Now we're gonna put the fried zucchini on top.
Fried
zucchini is really yummy.
It's really what?
Yummy.
Yummy.
Everything fried is yummy, right?
So the point of this is you got two crunchy things.
The point of it tastes delicious.
It tastes delicious, but one of the gustatory experiences is you got the crunchy wild rice on the bottom and the crunchy fried zucchini on top, and in between is a French custard.
I really forget every year how much work this is to do. It has three or four stages, but every year I can't wait to make one, and so now my year's fulfilled.
Okay, so we haven't quite finished setting the table, but here we have zucchini leek and mozzarella. What's the word? Tart,
yeah,
or French custard, and wild rice. A quickly thrown together. What kind of salad?
It's a Caesar salad.
Caesar salad, in which you can use the egg separation technique that we demonstrated for both the waffles and the squash blossom pudding we did the day before. I have a couple new. Salt selections, birch smoked salt we picked up in a trip to Iceland when we took off for a couple weeks from the market. Someone else stepped up to volunteer to manage it. And we have a lemon salt from Hippie Pilgrim, which is available at the barbecue store on Southern Ave called Bones Brothers. We didn't finish because we didn't do the napkins. And this little thing here is related to the dish. French custard of the dish, and the music, which is the Gypsy Kings, which are from France. And I got this in Montreal. I kind of stole it from a restaurant. And
it's not a custard either.
Well, they spoke of it, the commentary of it was as if it was a French custard, and they were talking about the contrast.
In the book?
Yes. and they on the liner notes on the back. Oh. The editor, the food critic. So anyway, the reason I grabbed the Gypsy Kings is because, like this dish, it is a patois. Gypsy Kings sing in a patois of French, Spanish, and Romani, which is a language of the Gypsy people. And that's kind of our cooking. Melange, or patois, of different styles in almost every meal. And then we also had a little argument about the what you do with the eggs for what kind of salad?
It's a Caesar salad.
Caesar salad. What I remember is you separate the eggs and you only use the yolks. She remembers using the whole egg, but that's another story. Yeah,
but you don't separate them and whip the egg whites.
No, you don't whip the egg whites for the for the Caesar salad. All right. Then we have the salt. I brought this. Janet says the salt's not really necessary for this. It's salty and crispy enough, and you don't need the salt for that. But we have some bread that Janet made with the sourdough starter that we showed you in a, or we're showing you in another show. And so it's nice to have with a little olive oil. And that's in a jar one of her students gave her. And when you wanna have bread with olive oil, it's also nice to have a dipping powder specifically for olive oil and bread. And then the last thing we'll say is it's nice to use these types of napkin rings. Go nicely around napkins. Or you can do something really simple, which is take a French looking napkin out of a drawer and throw it in the top of a wine glass. You don't have to do much to it. If you really want it, you can iron it, but that's it for today.